in Seattle, Washington, getting ready for a Sweet 16 matchup between 2-seed UConn and 3-seed Ohio State, as we welcome you to the NCAA Women's Championship presented by Capital One. The winner of this contest will take on the winner of Tennessee and Virginia Tech. That game later on tonight on ESPN. Too, as we welcome you courtside. Hey everybody, Ryan Rucco alongside the Hall of Famer Rebecca Lobo. So happy to be with you for what should be a fantastic evening of basketball in a city that loves women's basketball, Seattle, Washington. For UConn, an unorthodox season, Rebecca. This was not the normal road, but here they are in a 29th straight Sweet 16. And Aaliyah Edwards, a big reason why.
Yeah, certainly some challenges for Connecticut this season, but their consistency has come from Aaliyah Edwards, leading the team in scoring at 17 a game, 9 rebounds a game. She has been relentless when she catches the ball in the paint, shooting 85% from the field in the tournament. She has improved her outside shot, a great passer from there as well, and can defend any position on the floor.
Heard Rebecca talk about the numbers in the tournament. They have been terrific for Aaliyah Edwards. For a little more on UConn, let's send things over to Holly Rowe.
Well, UConn has gotten an important piece of the puzzle back. AZ Fudd has had a roller coaster of a season. Injured early in December against Notre Dame, she did try to return from a knee injury against Georgetown in January, but it didn't go great. Later, she was out for another month before returning to this team in the Big East tournament, and her return has lifted their spirits and really changed their offense. Her ability to space the floor was a huge piece of their win against Baylor in the second round. 16 points in the third quarter. She had not had a 20-point scoring game since November, but at the right place at the right time. AZ Fudd said she has never felt better. She said, I have to trust that my knee is stable. She believes that she can be a big impact for UConn today.
All right, thanks a lot, Holly. Meanwhile, for Ohio State, here's a team seeking its first Elite Eight since 1993, and they too have gotten back a key player from injury, J.C. Sheldon.
J.C. Sheldon missed 23 games on the season. So important to this team on both ends of the floor. Offensively, she pushes the pace. She leads the team in assists per game. She's a catalyst for them on the defensive end as well, in particular in their press. And in their last round game against North Carolina, scored their last 5 points, including this one, the game winner.
Sheldon with big numbers through these first two games of the tournament. Not just star players in this game, but also two offenses that can really hum. For more on that, here's Andrea Carter.
Thanks, Ryan. Well, you said these offenses can hum, and there are only two teams in the nation that have 5 players each averaging 10 points per game at over 40% from the field, and that is our two teams that we have out on the floor, UConn and Ohio State. These offenses operate at such a fast pace. Speed is their strength, not only in the full court off of their defense in transition, but also in the half court. Backdoor cuts, spacing, misdirection. You can expect to see it all from both teams today. If defense doesn't make a stand, Ryan, it might be a race to 100.
I think the audience would very much enjoy that.
So would I, and you.
I don't know if Gino Auriemma and Kevin McGuff would, but I think the rest of the viewers probably would enjoy it.
The one who got there first would enjoy it.
That's right. Gino Auriemma, an 11-time national champion, his 29th Sweet 16. Talked about it yesterday and said, it's kind of mind-boggling when you think about it. Yeah, it is. 29 straight, and for Kevin McGuff in his 10th season as head coach of Ohio State, 4th Sweet 16 berth, 2nd straight, a program on the rise that is seeking its first Elite Eight since 1993. The Sweet 16 underway for UConn and Ohio State.
Ohio State starting out in man-to-man. That is their primary defense, but they love to pick up in the full court when they can.
Rui Lopez Senechal does not need much space to do exactly that. Let's take a look at our Capital One starting lineups. J.C. Sheldon joining the backcourt by Taylor Fury. Taylor Mitzel, big-time threat from three. Ebony Walker coming off maybe her best game with Ohio State. And Cody McMahon, a tremendous freshman. Here's Mitzel, little push shot, too strong, and the weak side rebound hauled in by UConn. Take a look at the UConn starting lineup. Here's Juhas, the transfer from Ohio State, had it stripped away. And knocked out of bounds. You see Nika Mule, the starting point guard for UConn. An incredible season. Broke Sue Bird's longtime record for most assists in a single season in program history. And guess what? Yeah, the point goat is in the building, her hometown now.
Two number 10s running the point guard position at one point for UConn.
Nika Mule told us it is an honor to wear that number and joke, she's way better than me. Lopez Sanichal off the deflection, shot clock fading, Mule has to fire, gets it on the rim, nothing more, Sheldon after it for Ohio State.
Nika Mule defensively is going to be really important. She has the assignment of Taylor Mikesell.
Early attack from three, the follow won't go for McMahon, and then a lot of contact overzealous and a whistle as Lopez Sanichal took a shot. They call the foul on McMahon, her first, something to watch, a key player for an Ohio State team that works a very tight rotation.
She's an incredibly important piece to them. She's got a great motor. She's terrific getting defensive boards, pushing the ball the other way. One of their bigger, stronger defenders.
Right away, a steal off the press for Ohio State, but they give it right back. One of the keys of this game, how does UConn handle the persistent press of Ohio State? Lopez Sanichal on a three. The Fairfield transfer has acquitted herself beautifully at UConn.
You see Nika Mule at the top of the screen as the drive happens down the lane. Nice attack. Face guarding Taylor Mikesell.
Mikesell had a couple of early threes in the second round. Nice delivery, Mule. Uas, no. Game rebounding, and it's controlled by Walker for Ohio State. Sheldon will let it rip. A little too strong, and Uas another rebound. Edwards takes it into the paint. Been very aggressive of late, something Gino Auriemma has been encouraging, and we're going to have a travel on Aaliyah Edwards.
Guys, we've already seen Lopez Sanichal knock down two buckets, and if you watch her footwork on the catch, the 1-2 right into her shot, it is not easy to step with your opposite foot as a right-handed shooter to step left-right, highly skilled from Lopez Sanichal.
Also feels like she shoots so accurately when contested. She has been a season saver for UConn as they work through this year of injuries.
And relatively quiet offensively in the first two rounds of the tournament, single digits in each.
Here is Fudd, wide open, connects on a three. Says my bad to Aaliyah Edwards after the poor initial pass. Makes the possession stick.
This is an Ohio State team. Seven times this season they've come back from double-digit deficits. But it has been a problem for them at times to dig themselves into a hole. Kevin McGuff said they cannot afford to do that here against Connecticut.
Said we're going to have to be much more consistent. Talked about how Connecticut, now healthy, is one of the top teams in the country. Mikesell missed everything. Here comes Mule pushing pace for UConn. Bud gets some space. Missed that one. And nice box out from McMahon to keep Uas off the boards. Connecticut seeking its 17th straight trip to the Elite Eight. Walker has size on Mule. Trying to take advantage of that. Edwards came with help, and then Mule just ripped it away. Uas, nice look. Edwards alone. Timeout, Ohio State.
When Connecticut's roster is fully healthy, they can get you from outside or in. AZ Fudd wide open, one of the best pure shooters in the game. And then Aaliyah Edwards, the All-American, finishing an easy two inside. Connecticut loving it.
Another Another team has punched their ticket in front of a mostly home crowd. South Carolina train keeps rolling. They nabbed their 41st straight win, beating UCLA by 16. They head to their third straight Elite Eight, where they'll play Maryland on Monday. The Greenville Regional wraps up for the day. Seattle, it's on you.
All right, Al, thank you very much. Taking a look at South Carolina. They just keep rolling. That is what they're shooting for. Trying to become the 10th undefeated champion, the 5th school with 3 titles, and the 4th to win back-to-back titles. The last repeat champion. Got to go back to Connecticut when they won titles each year of Brianna Stewart's tenure with the Connecticut Huskies. For UConn, they have to love the start here, Rebecca, a 10-2 beginning. And for Ohio State, I know this can be part of the issue with the style of how they play.
Well, one of their great strengths can also be one of their big weaknesses for Ohio State, and that is their pace and how quickly they can shoot in transition or the quarter court. When they're shooting the three ball and making it, it can build a lead quickly. When they're not, it can fuel a team the other way. They started this game only 1-for-7.
And they turn it over here. Fudd on the steal, will pull up. Doesn't get the roll. Edwards the offensive rebound. And the tie-up inside. Possession arrow belongs to Ohio State. That was something Kevin McGuff talked to us about yesterday. He said he was making his team aware of those early threes, sometimes taking too many of them, and that being the primary reason why they've gotten themselves in those double-digit holes until they have dug themselves out of them.
And Taylor Mikesell, the player for their team who has the green light no matter what time of the possession, which is why Connecticut's sending so much defensive attention to her. Ebony Walker again able to score inside, coming off her best game of the season in the last round.
And a steal and a foul here. There's the Ohio State press. Second steal they've gotten off of it.
And another Ohio State strength that could be a weakness. They turn you over.
Yeah.
But they can also turn it over themselves. And they had 21 in their last round win against North Carolina. So they need to take care of the basketball. They need to have patience on the offensive end and hit shots.
See Ricky Harris into the game off the bench for Ohio State with it here. Walker faces up, missed everything, and it tilts out of bounds to Connecticut. Timeout on the floor. The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship on ABC is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Yeah, but look at points off.
Come on, baby, let's go.
Put on your dancing shoes.
For the third straight year, every NCAA Women's Basketball Championship game is on the networks of ESPN. For more information, go to NCAA.com. Your home for all 90 NCAA championships. All games are on the ESPN networks and the ESPN app. 10-4 lead for UConn in this Sweet 16 matchup with Ohio State. Let's check in with Holly Rowe.
In that last UConn huddle, Gino Auriemma is ripping his team for not being strong enough against the press. He has put in several different things to try to help them. He said, as soon as you get the ball, you have to turn and face other people. It is all of us that have to take the pressure off of them. You've got to step up with hands high, be strong with the ball. He did try to prepare his team for this pressure of Ohio State, having them practice against their biggest, strongest, longest male practice players before they left stores. But he is frustrated right now that they're not doing a nice enough job against this pressure.
And Holly, their last turnover was Nika Mule not waiting for Leah Edwards to be set so she could then come and meet the basketball. Much better job on this possession, getting it over cleanly.
And Ohio State will press all game long as Sheldon knocks it away. Edwards gets it back. Would have been a 5th UConn turnover. Edwards can't finish it. Here comes the freshman McMahon. She can go coast to coast, and here she will.
a little Alyssa Thomas in her game right there. Quinny McMahon is outstanding, getting the defensive board, facilitating the other way, full speed, and look at her frame, so big and strong.
Nice cut from Uas and a good find from Lopez Seneschal.
And that's the thing against the press. If you can get it over the front line quickly, you're going to have a numbers advantage that can lead to a layup.
12-6, UConn lead. McMahon can't finish it, but gets the whistle, and Cody McMahon is going to shoot two.
Watch McMahon. She gets the basketball head up, and look at how fast she goes the other way. Big, strong, can finish inside. Beautifully done with the left hand.
And against the press, Juhas ended up with the open layup. That is the second foul on Aaliyah Edwards. So early foul trouble for Edwards, who will head to the bench for Connecticut.
And we talked about how important Aaliyah Edwards has been to this team. Not only the way she's been scoring, but she's the one player who can defend any position. And she is one of their better passers as well.
One for two at the line goes McMahon. Caroline Ducharme into the game off the bench for Connecticut. Ducharme also had an injury-riddled season, a key piece for UConn. Lopez Seneschal airmails it. Flagged down by the Ohio State transfer, Juhas. Juhas, a deep two. No good. Fighting back for the rebound was Harris, and Ohio State controls. Attempt a little too strong.
And Miku Lashikova has that kind of range, so you have to come out on her when she catches it there. And Dorka Juhas certainly has that range inside.
And that was a concern for Kevin McGuff, the easy baskets from UConn. Such a well-oiled machine offensively. Talking to the Ohio State players as well, they said their number one focus was guarding, taking away those easy looks as Sheldon works her way into a whistle against Juhas.
Nika Mule with her head up, and she is very, very good at this. And that's the direct entry pass into her post player in transition. Great catch and finish by Juhas, but that play happens because of Nika Mule.
Rebecca, another thing too, that pass to Dorka Juhas, why is it open? Because on the weak side, Mike Sell is defending AZ Fudd. So she's getting out on the three-point shooters. Who else is being defended? Caroline Ducharme, defended by Jaycee Sheldon, getting out to defend the three-pointers, leaves the middle open.
Dre, this is something that you and I talked about in the studio. When AZ Fudd and Caroline Ducharme are on the floor together, it's going to leave you a cleaner lane because they have such good shooters on the perimeter.
Fudd has struggled at times here with this Ohio State press. Another turnover force. McMahon can't twist into the bucket. Kept alive. Nikusha Lashikova takes, can't hit from three, and Fudd the rebound. Lopez Seneschal lines it up and knocks down the three. Lou Lopez Seneschal now with 8 points in this opening quarter. First team all Big East this season after almost 1,600 career points at Fairfield as Sheldon gets free and lays it in.
What a great backdoor cut by Jaycee Sheldon as Connecticut was denying on the wing.
McMahon got a hand on it, knocked it off Ducharme, and Ohio State forces another Connecticut turnover. 6 turnovers already for UConn. Ohio State, 6th best turnover margin in Division I this season. 3rd most points off of turnovers. McMahon, what a spin, and fillets it home. Beautiful touch and footwork from the freshman, Cody McMahon. This time, Mule able to break the press. Frenetic pace at times to this opening quarter. Ducharme looking for the angle, barrels in, lost it out of bounds, and that is going to be a charge. Or will they just say out of bounds? Either way, it's going to be Ohio State basketball. And we'll take another look.
Caroline Ducharme driving inside, loses the handle.
They're going to say last hit the head of Ducharme. No foul, but it is Ohio State basketball. That's a 7th Connecticut turnover.
Turnovers have been a problem all season for the UConn Huskies. They're averaging 16.2 turnovers a game, Ryan. That's the most since 2000, most in 23 years.
Nikolashi Kova has the size on Fudd. Double comes. McMahon busts through. Fudd on the dig. Comes up with a steal. Here's AZ Fudd. To Sean. Resets with Mule, asking for a screen. Connecticut leading by four. Deflected pass. Ends up with Ducharme. In and out on a three. Juhasz keeps it alive. Ducharme loses it in eighth Connecticut turnover. Underneath, wide open. Theory finishes on the delivery from McMahon. And a nice response from Ohio State after a struggle to the start of this one. Here is Fudd. Short on a three. Harris on the box out, and it last hit Connecticut. Ohio State ball. The NCAA Men's Basketball Championship continues tonight on TBS. For more information on game times and networks, go to NCAA.com. Well, if you're Kevin McGuff in Ohio State, you have to be simply delighted by what your press and your pressure has done to Connecticut.
Absolutely, and the way you respond, too, to digging yourself a little bit of a hole. But as we said, it's something that they have experience with this season.
A 6-0 burst from Ohio State. You see, they started 3 of 13 from the floor, 3 of 3 since. Slight difference game and shot clock. Here's McMahon giving it back. Walker with one to shoot. Walker traveled, and Ohio State turns it over. Their fifth of the quarter. 1.2 to operate here for Connecticut. Fudd gets it in, and that's how the first quarter will end. A 17-15 lead for the Huskies. After one, we will chat with Ohio State head coach Kevin McGuff when we get back. Nice finish to the corner for his squad.
Welcome back to Seattle here with Ohio State coach Kevin McGuff. And coach, your press has done its job. 8 first quarter turnovers forced. How do you capitalize better on the offensive end?
Well, that's the thing. I thought we had some really good shots around the rim to start. We didn't make them, and they're making their shots. We're not. But then we're getting enough opportunities. We just got to knock down some of those shots. And we also got to have a little bit better spacing so we can drive the ball at the rim.
This group hasn't been on this stage before. What do you see from your freshman, Cody McMash? She just seems unafraid.
Yeah, no, she's just got a joy for the game. She's going to play, whether she's at an open gym in Columbus, Ohio, or she's here in the Sweet 16. She's going to play hard and compete no matter what.
Thanks, coach.
Thank you.
5 points in that opening quarter for Cody McMahon. And the press, Drea, really effective for Ohio State.
Absolutely, Ryan. I mean, this is what Ohio State is known for. And give Ricky Harris and the second line a ton of credit for Ohio State at jumping that next pass and really playing one step ahead. You have to trust your ability to go. You have to trust your teammates. You can't hesitate going for that steal. And, Rebecca, this first play leads to some offense, or this first play didn't lead to offense, but it led to something really important.
And that was Aaliyah Edwards' first foul. And she remains on the bench because she's picked up her second foul midway through the first quarter.
You see the game summary. Lopez Seneschal with 8 points to lead UConn. Ohio State with 12. It's 15 points in the paint. And most of those points in the paint came once Edwards picked up her second foul.
And Coach McGuff talked about it, you know, getting spacing so that they can drive down the lane. They have done a really nice job of that so far in this game.
Juhasz, Ducharme, Mule, Aubrey Griffin, and AZ Fudd, the 5 for Connecticut, as Juhasz gets swallowed up inside by Ebony Walker. Here is Cody McMahon out there with Sheldon, Mike Sell, and Taylor Theory. Sheldon straight on, airballs it. That makes a funny stink face afterwards.
Connecticut, the lineup they have in now, switching every spawn ball screen.
Fudd gets it into Juhasz. Back to Fudd against the press of Ohio State. Fudd picks up the dribble, needs some help. Connecticut flirting with a violation here, and it is a 10-second violation on Connecticut.
AZ Fudd does not look comfortable to me handling the basketball against pressure, which is slightly surprising because early in the season, before her injury, she was doing that exceptionally well in games against Texas and NC State. She was handling the ball confidently, and she does not look confident so far in this one.
Remember, it was a real point of emphasis in the tournament last year at practice for Gina Orienta with getting AZ Fudd comfortable with breaking the press as Griffin comes up with a rebound on the miss from Walker. Aubrey Griffin, a player Connecticut did not have a season ago, missed the entire year due to injury as Ohio State forces another turnover. McMahon able to get her hands on that one. 11 Connecticut turnovers. McMahon buries the three, and Ohio State has its first lead of the game. Connecticut raced out to a 10-2 lead, but Ohio State forcing turnovers right and left. Here's another one. But then a held ball. Ohio State has the possession arrow. Will retain it. That's 12 Connecticut turnovers as Aaliyah Edwards comes back into the game for the Huskies.
And that's why it's so vitally important for Ohio State to make their shots. Because when they make their shots, they can set up in that press. And we've seen how much difficulty it's given Connecticut so far.
You see the way Ohio State has dominated the turnover story this season. Timeout taken by Connecticut. The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship presented by Capital One on ABC is brought to you by Under Armour. Protect this house.
Coming up with the degree halftime report, Maryland, South Carolina into the Elite Eight. We will get you all of those highlights from the earlier games. But in terms of this one, Monica McNutt tried to tell y'all about that Ohio State press.
I mean, I'm just saying, UConn, what y'all gonna do about this pressure? You're on the way to 22 turnovers, which is the money number for Ohio State.
I know, but bring Aaliyah Edwards back in. That's your best player because when she was out, they went on a 12-5 run.
All right, we'll see how the second half closes out. We'll see you at the half. Let's get it back to Ryan and Rebecca.
Well, thank you very much, El. Nikki gets her wish. Aaliyah Edwards back in, and there's the turnover numbers and the turnover story for UConn.
Again, it's been a problem for Connecticut all season long, but in particular here early, five turnovers on their last six possessions.
And we heard Monica talk about that magic number. Ohio State 18-0 this season with forcing 20-plus turnovers.
Go right at her.
Yeah, McMahon instead. Dishes out to Sheldon. Here's Walker, six to shoot. McMahon straight on three is good. Cody McMahon has WNBA GMs dreaming in this first half.
I love watching Cody McMahon play.
And another steal. Sheldon loses it out of bounds. Last hit Mule. 13 turnovers already in this first half for Connecticut.
Ohio State takes great pride in this defense. It's called 22, and the players say we prepare for this all season long. In the offseason, they do a ton of running. Even during practices in the course of the season, they build in running drills so that they are in exceptional condition right now. It looks like J.C. Sheldon is getting some blood wiped off of her leg. But they take pride in this. They know when they have broken down a team, and they can run all day. They'll tell you they are in an exceptional condition. They can run all day, and it's because they've been working on it since the summer to be able to press like this.
And Holly, it fuels you. When you're pressed, you get results out of it. It gives you so much more energy to continue it.
I got a little scared when J.C. Sheldon said they have single full days dedicated to running in the offseason. Periods. Full days where they just do all different kinds of running to help prepare them for this moment.
And she's a player who never looks tired.
And since Sheldon has come back, it has made a significant difference in the effectiveness of that press. Sheldon, all Big Ten first team a season ago, averages nearly four steals per game in her 11 this season. Missed a huge chunk of time with a foot injury. McMahon got a hand on it, kept it alive. Edwards comes up with a steal. Ohio State, a 12-0 run dating back to the first quarter. Five turnovers on Connecticut's first five possessions of the second quarter. They get into the half court here. Here is Mule. Working behind Edwards. Juhas. And a foul is going to go against Ohio State.
Ohio State with such good, quick, active hands. We've seen it a few times when Connecticut has had some dribble penetration, able to get deflections, certainly plenty of steals.
Taylor Fury with her first personal. Ohio State seeking its first Elite Eight appearance since 1993. Connecticut aiming for a 17th straight trip to the Elite Eight. Mule has its trip. Another turnover. Mike Sell to get ahead. Beautiful transition break. And the finish from Fury. And a foul here on Sheldon as she went for the steal. A 14-0 Ohio State run.
Quick hands. We talked about the quick hands, and Mike Sell has them there. And her teammates know as soon as we get a turnover, we are running the other way. Unselfish extra pass basketball.
Rebecca, UConn has six turnovers in the first 3 minutes of the second quarter. Griffin might as well be a turnover, blocks it out of bounds.
Sped up. Connecticut is sped up. This is a team on the season has shot 50% from the field. They simply can't get enough field goals up because of all the turnovers.
Drea?
Well, that's another thing. You all are talking about the physicality and the toll it takes going against the press, but it also takes a mental toll to go against full court pressure. You break it full speed and you're going so fast to then, Rebecca, like you said, slow your mind down and make good decisions. It's very hard to do.
McMahon on the follow. It's a 16-0 Ohio State run dating back to the first quarter. Connecticut has been completely befuddled by this relentless press of Ohio State. Lopez Seneschal, she travels and immediately crumples to the hardwood, grabbing at her right leg. This is a Connecticut team who's had to navigate all season without its best player, Paige Beckers. Gino Auriemma has talked about the irregular road this group has taken to this moment. The continuity not there, but the heart and the grit has been as Lopez Seneschal, under her own power, heads to the Connecticut bench. You see the right knee buckle. Lopez Seneschal grimace and grab at the right leg.
Not only Connecticut's leading scorer, Ryan, but she is a solid ball handler. This is a game where Connecticut certainly needs that.
Last two seasons, 232 games lost due to injury for Connecticut. But gets a hand on it. Here's McMahon. McMahon gets tripped, and that foul's going to be on who? If it's Edwards, it's her third. And it is Edwards, and it is her third.
Great job by Cody McMahon to attack the basket, and especially she knows that Aaliyah Edwards has two fouls, and this is just one of those situations where the defender can't even really prevent the foul.
But Gino Auriemma, as we see Lopez Seneschal, is going to take things to the carpet. He used a great analogy about McMahon, Gino did. He said, it's like watching Saquon Barkley. Just the force with which she runs with her speed and size, and McMahon with 14 in this first half. So, danger time here for Connecticut. Three fouls on Edwards. She's on the bench. Lopez Seneschal having her leg looked at. A 17-0 Ohio State run and a foul here against the Buckeyes. Connecticut has eight turnovers in the quarter and no field goals. They don't even have a field goal attempt this quarter. Now they do, and a make as Bud lays it in.
4.5 minutes without a field goal attempt in the quarter.
Incredible. 16 turnovers in the half for Connecticut. Here's Sheldon weaving, taking, and banking. That look has been steadily on the face of Gino Auriemma in this first half. After a quick start from Connecticut, got out to a 10-2 lead. They break the press here. Fudd finds Duchamp, and it's a three. Nice job by McMahon. It last hits Ohio State, though, and another chance here for Connecticut.
J.C. Sheldon, a quick ball handler, a good decision maker for Ohio State, and here behind the back. Looks a little bit like the game winner. She gets a couple steps closer than she did against North Carolina, but so strong going to the basket.
Hit that game winner with 1.8 seconds to go in the second round to beat UNC after they went on a torrid rally at the end of the fourth quarter. Griffin just whips it out of bounds. And Dorka Juha says, come on. Just again, to what Dre was talking about, too, sped up even when you break the
completely
pressure.
Completely uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Connecticut completely uncomfortable offensively, and that is so out of character from what we're used to seeing from them. And all the credit goes to Ohio State's defense.
17 turnovers now. How about an update on Lou Lopez Seneschal from Holly Row?
Well, guys, from what I have observed, this looks like a positive update. Lou is on the bike right now, getting that knee moving. They also did some really extensive stretching with her, pushing her foot all the way to her bottom. It shows some great flexibility in that knee. Normally, this isn't something they'd do if there was a ligament type of issue. This is a positive right now to see Lou on the bike. I'll let you know as soon as I know more.
All right, Holly, good information there, and hopefully for her sake, Lou Lopez Seneschal is able to return. Gino Auriemma was apoplectic there after yet another turnover, trying to direct Nika Buell. Here's Theory up under and off, rebound Duchamp. It's an 11-point Ohio State lead. Connecticut led 17-15 after the first. They've scored just 2 points here in the second quarter. And nearly another turnover. Here's Fudd. Juhas backing in, fading away, and gets the whistle against Taylor Theory. That will be the second foul on Theory, one of the best defenders on this Ohio State team.
And especially when Aaliyah Edwards was in the game with Dorka Juhas, Connecticut has the size advantage, but it hasn't mattered because Ohio State has the quickness advantage and has been getting deflections, and it's been just so difficult for Connecticut to even get it over half court to take advantage of their size inside.
Dorka Juhas, we told you, a transfer from Ohio State, had a lot of success with the Buckeyes, was two times a member of first team All Big Ten, and I thought it was really encouraging, Rebecca, just hearing the way Kevin McDuff talked yesterday about Dorka Juhas leaving Ohio State. No animosity,
yeah.
Really complimentary of her, and also the Connecticut coaching staff and the way they further developed Dorka Juhas.
Yeah, and her goal is to play in the WNBA, came to UConn after her junior year, has been here the last two seasons, and he was absolutely complimentary of her and how her game has grown.
Those are the first free throws attempted for Connecticut this game. A 30-20 Ohio State lead. Here is Sheldon. Kept the left foot down. Connecticut wanted a walk. And we're going to get a foul instead. It will be called against Connecticut. And it's going to go against Nika Buell, her first. Buell, the two-time reigning Big East Defensive Player of the Year.
Feels a little bit like Connecticut has been on their heels the whole game, both defensively and offensively, whereas Ohio State has just been attack, attack, attack.
Harris fading in. Nice job defensively there for Clark. It got well up. Here's AZ Fudd. Number one recruit last season. Duchamp run off, kicks out, Griffin. Back to Duchamp, wide open, can't hit the three, Juhas the rebound, another chance for Connecticut. Fudd will fire, and hit! A much-needed delivery for Connecticut from AZ Fudd, superb applause.
Those are Connecticut's first second-chance points. Ohio State had been doing an outstanding job on the defensive glass.
Fudd had a monster third quarter against Baylor in the second round, where she scored 16. Gets called for the foul here, and McMahon is going back to the line.
So important for Connecticut, for AZ Fudd to be able to hit from the perimeter. Great ball movement off the offensive glass to get her the basketball. And then she picks up the foul on this end. But not on Cody McMahon. She is an absolute delight to watch. And there's some pretty good freshmen in the freshman class. Ty Latson is one of them at Florida State. Cody McMahon has been the most impressive freshman I have seen all season long.
For a little more on Cody, let's check in with Holly Rowe.
Well, she has. This is her 25th straight double-double. I talked to her mom, Stacy, about it before the game, and she said, you know, it started with her grandfather, Howard. He was a good ball player, but when his dad died, he took over his pastoral job in Dayton, Ohio. Both mom and brother played, but Cody's the one that's taken it the farthest. And she said she's just always had this calm sense of confidence about her. Her name is Cody. It's unique. She said it's cutie with an O.
Very nice, Holly. Yeah, 25 straight games scoring in double figures. She has had a huge first half, 18.
She just said cutie with an O. I love that.
Come on.
That's not the good
one. Uhas over to Fudd. Ball fakes the three. Back to Uhas. Open for three. No.
Again, great defensive board by Ohio State.
Connecticut 4 for 14 from three. On the reverse side. Walker able to finish. And just when Connecticut was getting a little rhythm, the Ohio State lead back to 11. Griffin is trapped and fouled. It's on McMahon. And that will be the second personal on Cody McMahon.
And I mentioned that, you know, Connecticut having a size advantage. Ohio State is dominating the points in the paint, 20-8. And it's been off mostly dribble, penetration, and score.
But one more thing on McMahon. She lights up the room. Huge personality, incredible presence. Nothing about her feels like a freshman.
She lights up the room. She lights up her opponents.
Griffin, this is the free throw.
Yeah, you look at McMahon and whether, you know, I don't know if she'll be WNBA draft eligible after her junior year or her senior year. But that certainly looks like a future number one pick.
Yeah. Both free throws missed by Griffin. Connecticut 1 for 4 from the line in the half. They have had Aaliyah Edwards on the floor for very limited minutes because of three fouls. Here's Sheldon, the hesitation, the scoop, and a foul against Uhas.
Yeah, that's a tough call on Dorka Uhas, and I thought the previous possession, the call on Azy Fudd, was a tough one as well. But Ohio State forces the whistles because of how their dribble penetration is getting them into the lane.
What do you think upon further review?
I need to see another angle. But again, Ohio State is in such great attack mode. That's how you get to the free throw line.
Right, you get rewarded for that.
Yes, you do.
Sheldon with 8 points now. Ohio State 8 of 10 from the line. Fudd bounces off of Harris. Out to Mule. Mika Mule just 2 assists in this first half. Mule turns the corner, lays it in on McMahon, who had to be careful playing with two fouls. Now a 14-second difference game and shot clock. A massive second quarter from Ohio State. McMahon goes backdoor. McMahon can't finish it. Rebound Duchamp. She gets tripped. Connecticut in the bonus. Free throws for Caroline Duchamp.
But another shot in the paint for Ohio State. And this is a team that so much can rely on their three-point shot. Only 2 of 9 from three today, but it hasn't mattered because of all the paint touches they're getting off of dribble penetration.
Rebecca, you have been in Gino Auriemma locker rooms at the half. 18 turnovers from Connecticut, 10 in the second quarter. What's that halftime communication going to be like?
Well, obviously, you know, talking through his players about being better against the pressure, but the one thing I know about Coach Auriemma is kind of the more frazzled the team could be is the more calm he will be. So I would expect actually a very calm locker room with him challenging his team, but also helping them navigate some of the challenges that they have had so far in the first half.
Also, I've struggled from the free throw line, 2 for 6 now. The clock is turned off. Here's Sheldon. 4 seconds left. Sheldon's jumper. Off back iron. No. Walker gets it away. And that is how the second quarter will end. Ohio State's ferocious defensive attack forces 18 Connecticut turnovers. Cody McMahon scores 18 first half points. And Ohio State with a 10-point halftime lead on Connecticut. Cody McMahon is with Holly Rowe.
Well, Cody, how is the pressure just feeding this team right now, forcing all these turnovers?
Yeah, you know, we heard UConn, you know, talking about our press and how, you know, they're just going to break it and score in the half court. But, you know, we came out wanting to attack them right away, and I feel like we're doing that with our 22.
There's a famous quote, AJ, nothing but a number. You're a freshman. This is your first Sweet 16. How are you so comfortable and confident right now?
I feel like you thrive best when you're confident. And right now, you know, I have nothing else to lose. You know, just got to give my all and come out here and, you know, try and win and help my team win.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, the Big Ten Freshman of the Year shining on the big stage. 13 in the second, 18 in the first half. For McMahon, Ohio State, a 36-26 lead on Connecticut, trying to make the Elite Eight for the first time since 1993. Time to send things to L. Duncan in the studio for halftime.
Thank you, Ryan. Welcome to the Degree Halftime Report. For just the sixth time in tournament history, UConn trailing by double digits at halftime. I'm Elle Duncan. She's Monica McNutt. She is Nikki Fargus. Honestly, I know they're the Huskies, but you could call them the UConn Paninis because they're getting that work in the press.
I'm done with her, just so know. You know. I'm done. That's all. Continue.
No, but walk us through it. I mean, it's been a huge issue, and they clearly don't have an answer.
I just want to say Cody McMahon also heard you, sis. Anyway, let's get to it. Let's go inside the tape, shall we? This is a little bit of this Buckeyes pressure, y'all. Okay, I just want to freeze it right here, and I just want everybody to take note of how this team, the four guards in this press, are going to move on a string. They are connected through their entire press. Let's clear it, and let's run it. Every time J.C. Sheldon goes or Taylor Mikesell goes, this back line is moving accordingly, right? So we'll freeze it right here. This is now where it becomes problematic. J.C. Sheldon already knows that the ball is coming toward Juha's here. She's ready to break on the pass. And, of course, everybody is matched up on these back ends, right? So that means it's money time to get this basketball. Pressure, pressure, pressure. The middle is taken away. J.C. Sheldon, Mikesell do a great job. Let's check out one more play in the half court this time. Pause it right here. This is just wreaking havoc, right? You've got Theory, I believe, and Cody McMahon up here. And then you're going to get Ebony Walker, who's going to have to split these two, right? She's willing to move as she sees this vision is looking this away, right? So she's ready to break. Let's clear it, and we'll watch it. Ebony does a great job of splitting these two, but more importantly, the pressure on the ball results in the ultimate turnover. McMahon gathers herself. Poise is so important. And I don't need to draw anything on the rest of this because this is just an Ohio State bucket. They were poised once they allowed their defense to lead to offense. Points off turnovers for this squad so far in this ballgame, y'all, 19.
That's a lot. You know, UConn started the game really sticking to their game plan. You know, Senechal was key for them. Obviously, she went down with a knee, and I hope she comes back. But this UConn team has got to do a much better job in breaking the 2-2-1 press. Mm-hmm. And they've got to do that with passing the basketball. But this young lady right here has kept them in the game. Her ability to shoot the three, extend the defense, but more importantly, she's their leading scorer right now, and she was out most of the second quarter. So when you look at this UConn team and how do you get yourself back into this game down 10, one, taking care of the basketball is going to be key. But Aaliyah Edwards picking up her third foul. She picked up two in the first quarter. Then she picked up her third foul. And that player is one that they depend on. So how are you going to generate this offense? She's your best rebounder. She's your best post defender. And so if you don't go back and look at what AZ Fudd has been able to do, she's got to carry this team right now. She has the potential, she's got the capability, and she's got the shot to do so.
History tells us that this is Ohio State's game to lose. They are 21-0 when they force 18 turnovers. How many turnovers does UConn have right now?
19.
18, but close. There it is. So we'll certainly see. My thing couldn't have updated. There it is. Yes. Notre Dame versus Maryland, as again, one of these two teams looking to join Maryland and South Carolina. In the Elite Eight, we pick it up there halfway through the second. This was close at first. Sonia Citron, 14 points. She drives for the layup. But after the third quarter, I don't know what they were drinking. Diamond Miller and Cheyenne Sellers, what Gator, whatever they had going on, they came out gangbusters in the second half.
And got some secret stuff, y'all. They had just 6 points in the first half, to your point, Elle, and 30 points in the second half. But Cheyenne Sellers defensively, as the primary defender, holding those folks to 0 of 3 and forcing 5 turnovers. She did it on both sides of the ball.
Diamond Miller had 4 points in the first half. She had 12 in the second. Maryland ends up moving on to the Elite Eight. They absolutely roll in the Sweet 16. Shout out to Notre Dame for a fantastic season, but losing their starting backcourt eventually caught up with them. How about UCLA and South Carolina? A lot of talk about how UCLA played them earlier in the season, super tough. Wasn't the prettiest game for South Carolina, but alas, they did South Carolina things.
Well, UCLA had a good defensive plan against South Carolina team, but what they do is they wear on you. And if you've got Bree Beal knocking down shots from the three-point line, that opens up some things for this South Carolina team. I liked how Leah Boston said, you know what, I'm out of my range. Let me, again, bully the ball down and get some paint points. But this pass over the top to Cardoza, you can't match that height.
10 players scored for South Carolina. They win their 41st straight game, and they continue their pursuit of perfection. You take a look, the Greenville Region 1 bracket is complete. So on Monday, we'll see South Carolina facing Maryland for a chance to go to the Final Four. As for this game, Cody McMahon has been ridiculous. 18 points right now for an Ohio State team that's up 10 on UConn. We'll close things out on the other side of the break.
This halftime report is presented by Degree. It won't let you down. This halftime report is presented by Degree. It won't let you down.
Yeah, you go, do-si-do. Come on, baby, let's go.
Put on your dancing shoes.
To be clear, I was dancing to Lil Uzi Vert. I would have been two-stepping or line dancing always, no matter what. The road to Dallas continues as we see here the Seattle bracket. Virginia Tech and Tennessee still on the slate. They'll be our nightcap 6:30 tonight. ESPN2, they'll face the winner of this game, Ohio State and UConn. What are you looking forward to in that 1-4 matchup, guys?
Tennessee. Rekia Jackson didn't play in that first game. Mm-hmm. Let's see what she can do. And then, obviously, you got Kitley and Georgia Moore. It's going to be a battle.
I don't know. Is this still the three-point celebration? I don't know. The kids are doing so many different things. Or like a little bit of the... All right, well, I am not...
The gritty. Are you going to do the gritty?
Absolutely.
Our director Jocelyn got you ready.
Threes from Georgia Amar, inside play from Liz Kitley. There you go.
Yeah. Unparalleled success for Virginia Tech. It's been fantastic under Kenny Brooks. Tennessee back in a familiar place for them, but great success under Kelly Harper. Again, that game coming up 6:30 Eastern on ESPN2. But for now, more action on the way. J.C. Sheldon setting the pace. 8 points as her Buckeyes try to stamp their ticket to the first Elite Eight in 30 years. Thanks for watching Degree Halftime Report. Ryan, RL, Holly, Andrea, we'll take it from here.
Welcome back to the NCAA Women's Championship presented by Capital One in Seattle, Washington. Ohio State, a 10-point lead on UConn in this Sweet 16 matchup as we welcome you back courtside. Ryan Rucco alongside the Hall of Famer Rebecca Lobo. There is no doubt what the story of that first half was, the defense of Ohio State, the turnovers they force as we take a look at tonight's game changers presented by Under Armour.
Yeah, Ohio State wreaked havoc in the full court and in the quarter court. We get a chance to see what their pressure looked like. There were no open lanes, easy lanes for Connecticut to get the ball over half court. They were sped up. You saw the turnover from Nico Mule on the travel and then there as well. Everything was hard for Connecticut in terms of handling that pressure in the first half. And then when they did get it over half court, they had issues as well. And Ohio State, an outstanding job turning those turnovers into points the other way. But here, they get it over half court. Doesn't matter. If you turn your back, Ohio State going to smother you, exactly what they wanted to do in that first half.
You see who get the first half stats. We check in with Andrea Carter.
Well, as you look at Ohio State and their defense, it looks exactly like they're playing off of instinct on that end. And that is exactly what Cody McMahon was doing on offense as well. Playing off of instinct, playing with great effort. And as a freshman, making incredible decisions. 18 points on 6 of 11 from the field.
two assists and only one turnover. She's athletic, she's bouncy, but it's her ability to play without thinking and play at a fast speed that was extremely impressive. Played all 20 minutes in that first half and made the most of all of them, Ryan.
Yeah, 18 points, very impressive from the freshman. Let's check in with Holly Rowe.
Well, checked in with Gino Auriemma. Lou Lopez Senechal is going to give it a shot right now. You see her out on the court. She was shooting in pregame warmups there with a little bit of sensitivity on that right knee. They're not sure how much she can play. Talked to Gino about that pressure and the turnovers, and he said, guys have just got to be confident right now. Why aren't they confident? Don't let them get so rattled and get so sped up.
Here is Lopez Senechal driving and finishing. A good sign for Connecticut. And for Lou Lopez Senechal, you see the largest halftime deficits in tournament history for Connecticut. Today makes the list. They have lost every other time they have trailed by double digits at the half in the NCAA tournament. Walker straight on jumper, rims out, and Edwards on the rebound. Aaliyah Edwards limited in that first half with three fouls, played just 9 minutes. Here's Fudd, misses the layup. Rebound, McMahon pushing pace. Cody McMahon attacking Edwards wisely. 20 points for the freshman McMahon.
So smart, go at the player who is in foul trouble and then intercept the pass the other way.
Not a good decision from Nika Mule, and McMahon just blew the bunny on the other end.
She earned the right to blow the bunny.
She sure did. Fudd passes it low, gets it back. Here's Lou Lopez Senechal. A little too strong on a three. Fudd tried to whack it to where she thought Lopez Senechal still was, but she vacated.
Just a great decision by Cody McMahon in transition. Take it at the player in foul trouble. You know she's not going to be able to contest as heartily as she would without the fouls.
I liked your Alyssa Thomas comp earlier with the size, strength, and speed.
But she's got a jump shot.
Exactly. So you got to add something else in the mix. Sheldon able to save the possession for Ohio State. Here is Sheldon between two, flips it out of bounds, and they're going to say it stays here with Ohio State. Six on the shot clock. Well, so six to shoot for Ohio State as Sheldon will inbound. Here's Walker. Got to move quickly. Three to shoot. I'm not sure they realize it. Now Sheldon does. Hoist and misses everything. And a better start to this second half for Connecticut.
Well, they were able to get stops and therefore didn't have to deal with the pressure. But here we'll see if they're able to handle it any better.
Mule does. Fudd with space through the lane again. AZ Fudd unable to complete the layup. Gets it back though on the steal. Fudd has had some looks at the rim in this third quarter that she just has not converted. Edwards dumps it underneath and knocked out of bounds. Going to stay with Connecticut.
Wish we kept track of deflections because Ohio State has a ton of them. They have high hands. They have quick hands.
That's not what you've been doodling on your paper all game long. What is that then? Edwards. Puts it on the deck, Aaliyah Edwards. That's been a calling card of her play in recent weeks. Aggression from Aaliyah Edwards. Averaged 23 and a half points per game, shooting in the mid-80s from the floor through the first two games of this tournament. Here's Mike Sell. She's been quiet today, but flips that one in.
And once again, Ohio State with success attacking the basket, getting 2 feet in the paint off of dribble penetration.
First points for Taylor Mike Sell. One of the best three-point shooters in the country. Here's Fudd. Fudd trying to find some space. We'll peel it back out with Mule. And that is going to be an offensive foul on Aaliyah Edwards and her fourth. Let's take a look, Rebecca.
Oh.
Is there anything there?
I don't think so. I thought her first foul was a tough one in the full court, and then she had her feet where she tripped to get the third. That is a tough fourth foul.
That is a really really difficult fourth foul on a stage like this as McMahon misses the jumper. I'm not sure there was anything at all there. Here is Fudd. Pulls up from the elbow. Juhas underneath, trying to find space, and finishes. Through the contact, Dorka Juhas. The Ohio State transfer might have to take on an even larger load in that front court of Connecticut, with Edwards picking up her fourth foul. Edwards is staying in the game for the moment, but Ducharme getting ready to check in. Juhas eats up the attempt from Walker, and it'll stay here with Ohio State as Edwards checks out. Rebecca, it's been a theme throughout the game, but how does Connecticut navigate without the services of Edwards for what you think is at least the rest of the third quarter, if not more?
Well, not having Edwards wasn't their biggest issue in the first half. Their inability to break the press, and that starts for them on the defensive end of the floor. If they can get stops, then Ohio State can't set up the press, but there's no better way to set up the press than after free throws.
You see the numbers from Edwards in the first two rounds today. Very limited thanks to those four fouls.
Thanks to the foul trouble, but also the turnovers. If you can't get the ball into the quarter court, you certainly can't get it into your post player's hands.
And one thing we've seen as theory works her way to the line, Ohio State, they have been the aggressors all game long, both ends. And as you said earlier, Rebecca, normally when you do that, you are going to be on the right side of 50-50 whistles.
24 of their points have come in the paint. They've simply been dominant inside.
Here's Mule. Nice little fake to shake Sheldon and get it across the timeline. Juhas over to Lou Lopez Seneschal, playing after that leg injury in the first half. Hoping it's not her final collegiate game as she turns it over. That is 21 Connecticut turnovers.
She needed to make one more pass to the right wing, and then that player would have had the direct entry into Juhas.
At least two turnovers by every UConn player. Here's Theory, lost it momentarily. McMahon spins in, meets two. Nice help there from Juhas. Connecticut has done a fine job defensively in this game. It's on the offensive end where they have struggled, and then Ohio State has thrived defensively. Here's Lopez Seneschal on the attack, lays it in, plus the foul, and a chance for three for Lou Lopez Seneschal. It'll be Harris's second.
Great pass and great cut off the curl for Lou Lopez Seneschal, and Ohio State's done an outstanding job of not giving up backdoor plays, but here, Lopez Seneschal able to use their aggressiveness defensively against them.
Looks like they called the foul on Sheldon, not Harris. So number two on Sheldon. And Sheldon's looking up at the board saying, huh? Why is that on me? Sheldon and Harris were both there, but it's Sheldon who is hit with the foul. As Seneschal completes the three-point play. Seven-point game. Oh, the rejection, no. The foul on Ducharme, and Theory is going to shoot two.
Because Ohio State has such great three-point shooters, you see how much space there is for their dribble penetration to get in the lane because the defenders have to be out. Yeah, certainly a foul there. We heard it live, and then we just saw it on the replay.
You heard that, huh?
Did you just slap? Yes.
You have better ears than I do. One thing that Kevin McGough told us yesterday, he said, Taylor Theory doesn't get a lot of attention, but she is a seriously important factor for us, especially in this matchup against Connecticut.
She's just solid. She's 2 for 4 from the floor so far in this game, but coming in her first two games in the tournament, 9 for 10.
On the Big Ten all-defensive team, has 3 steals here today, and that is going to be another Connecticut turnover against the Ohio State Press. 22 turnovers, and Nika Mule has 6 turnovers and just 2 assists. Here's McMahon, turns the corner, rumbles in, gets denied, last hit heard, Connecticut basketball. Good defensive stop from Dorca Juhas. Still to come tonight, Virginia Tech, the 1 seed, taking on the 4 seed Tennessee. Virginia Tech in the building, that game 6:30 Eastern on ESPN2. Caitlin Clark helped lead the way in front of an electric crowd here in Seattle yesterday. And about the hometown young woman, Haley Van Lith, guiding Louisville to yet another Elite Eight. It continues Sunday on ESPN, 7 p.m. Eastern, Miami and LSU. And then Louisville and Iowa at 9 from here in Seattle. The Women's NCAA Championship Elite Eight Sunday at 7 and 9 on the ESPN networks and the ESPN app. Let's send things over to Holly Rowe.
Guys, Gino Auriemma in that last huddle kind of slammed his clipboard with his hands. You have got to help each other on this press break. He said, I've been saying this for months. Nika Mule having trouble getting that up in the 4-man press break by herself. People have got to come back on an angle and be ready just like that. That's what they went over in the last timeout. And then on offense, they need more activity. Their motion read offense, and they need to be moving more motion on this end.
Holly, to beat a press, every single player on the team has got to want the basketball, because if you don't, you will not find the angle to get it.
Juhas lays it in on the spin. Harris took a dive, and Juhas took advantage. 9 points, 7 rebounds for Dorca Juhas, who has probably been Connecticut's best player thus far today. Here's Sheldon. McMahon knocks down Griffin. The 3 won't go from Harris, and an opportunity here for Connecticut to creep a little closer. They've trailed by as many as 13. It's 7 now. Back door, Lopez Senechal lays it in. Nika Mule grimacing after she delivers the assist, hopping up and down, something bothering her, it looks like, with the left leg. But a timeout taken by Ohio State as Connecticut showing life here in this third. They've cut it to 5.
Ohio State up the lane, and Lou Lopez Senechal making the pay with the back door cut. Connecticut feeling a little something.
Connecticut building a little momentum in this third quarter. They've cut the Ohio State lead to 5. Nika Mule seemed to tweak her left ankle, though, moments ago, right there, as we check in with Holly Rowe.
Nika definitely came over to the bench grimacing and limping a little bit, but she did not receive treatment on the bench from their athletic trainer, Janelle Frisco. She said she's just okay. She's told her teammates around her, I'm good. And you see, she's one of the toughest people out there. Plus, she does wear those big protective ankle braces that may help a little bit in this situation.
And I'll say from experience, when you roll your ankle when you're on your toe like that, it hurts a lot less for a lot shorter period of time than when you do it when you're on your heel.
Ohio State is led by as many as 13, and they've forced 22 Connecticut turnovers thus far in this game. Mike Sell's runner is good. Connecticut's done a nice job keeping Mike Sell quiet in this game, but a big bucket there for Taylor Mike Sell. Here's Lou Lopez Senechal bouncing. Juhas gets fouled, and free throws coming for Dorca Juhas. And it's on McMahon. That will be her third.
Connecticut, when they've been able to break the press here in the third quarter, have done a much better job themselves getting the ball in the paint. Ryan, at the half, they had 10 points in the paint already here in the third quarter, 12.
Juhas, this is the first free throw. Connecticut now 3 of 8 from the line in this game.
Oh,
UConn 9 points, 8 rebounds, a couple of blocks. Misses both. Griffin last hit it, and it's Ohio State basketball. Tough to shoot that poorly from the free throw line when you're trying to overcome a double-digit deficit.
Look at the space right now in the lane for Ohio State.
Here's Sheldon. She will fire and hit from three. Just like that, it's back to double digits for the Buckeyes. Through Lopez Seneschal gathers. Here's Connecticut into their offense. Lopez Seneschal nails the jumper. So smooth off the dribble. That's 17 for Lou Lopez Seneschal, the only member of Connecticut who is in double figures. Now the steal, UHAS, great hands. Connecticut with numbers 4-on-2, Fudd handed to 3, and McMahon races in for the rebound. McMahon, great look, and the foul is called on Lou Lopez Seneschal as Theory is going to shoot a pair.
Lopez Seneschal trying to get there. Yeah, she's sliding to the side live. I didn't think it was a defensive foul, but she was certainly still moving laterally.
And not on the real estate, right call made, and Theory misses the first free throw. Gino Auriemma talked to us about this moment. He said, I always say to get to the regionals, your program can get you there. But to win at this time of year, you need a somebody. You need somebody who just insists on winning as Lopez Seneschal travels. And Connecticut turns it over. That's a somebody.
That's a somebody.
Paige Beckers, who Gino referenced this time last year in her performance in double overtime against NC State that got Connecticut to the Final Four. Will Connecticut have that somebody step up down the stretch? So far today, that somebody on the floor has been Cody McMahon. Here's Walker, can't lay it in, and a foul comes in late on Dorca UHAS, and free throws here for Ohio State. And that is number 3 on UHAS. Remember, Aaliyah Edwards already on the bench with 4. Walker misses the first. Now here's what's at stake for Gino Auriemma and Connecticut. They have a D1 record, 16 straight Elite Eight appearances. Last time they didn't make it, 2005. They've made the Final Four in a ridiculous 14 straight tournaments. Their last title, 2016. Ayanna Patterson getting ready to check in for Connecticut. UConn had shaved it down to 5 moments ago, back to 9 for Ohio State. Mule, the crossover, the kick. Griffin didn't take it. Poor to shoot. Griffin able to work her way into a huge foul. That is number 4 on Cody McMahon.
Frankly, I think there's been some questionable calls on both ends of the floor when it comes to play in the paint.
I mean,
there's nothing there.
Kevin McGuff is astonished, and reasonably so. Don't see anything that looks like a foul. And so now McMahon heads to the bench after picking up her 4th. And again, Connecticut struggling from the free throw line.
And you mentioned McMahon has been the someone in this game. She has been Ohio State's most important player.
Let's check in with Holly Rowe.
Didn't love it, but Cody didn't like it either. She came over the bench, looked at her teammates and said, that's crazy.
Yeah, I mean, there have been some seriously suspect calls on the interior called against both teams in this game. Sheldon dumps it. Theory unable to finish. Loose ball, and it ends up with Mule. Yes, Buell directing traffic with McMahon on the bench for Ohio State. Edwards on the bench where she's been most of this game for Connecticut. And that is yet another Connecticut turnover, their 24th.
It was deflected by Ohio State, I thought. I didn't know why Patterson was trying to save it.
Absolutely thought the same thing. Connecticut led this game 17-15 at the end of the first. They jumped out to a 10-2 lead, and then Ohio State turned on its pressure. Here's Sheldon. Hit a big three a few possessions ago. Sheldon on the attack, gets fouled by Patterson. And J.C. Sheldon is going back to the line. And when you talk to Ohio State players about their secret weapon, it's that young woman, Emmy Sheldon, the sister of J.C. Sheldon, who brings so much joy and inspiration to this Ohio State team. Pre-game, giving hugs to every member of this team. And when we talked with Taylor Mikesell before the start of the Sweet 16, she said, if there's a story that's key to our team that maybe doesn't get talked about enough, it's Emmy, as we check in with Holly. 10-point lead for Ohio State. Fudd finally gets one to drop in. Hazy Fudd now with 10 points. UConn is going to need her down the stretch. Theory turns the corner and gets the roll. Taylor Theory, a huge bucket to end the third, and Ohio State takes a 10-point lead into the fourth. Very interested to hear what Gino Auriemma has to say. He'll chat with Holly Rowe coming up next. Fourth quarter's coming up as well of this Sweet 16 matchup. The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship on ABC is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet? Moments ago, Holly Rowe caught up with Gino Auriemma.
Coach, down 10 to start the fourth quarter. Where does the composure and confidence have to come from to win this game?
Well, for me, probably, for one. I just think we're pressing so hard that anytime we get pretty decent ball movement down here, we get a good look at the basket, we get a bucket. Anytime we get a good defensive possession, we get a stop. It's just, we picked the worst day to actually be doing the things that we've been struggling with all year long. And those three quarters, it's all caught up to us. And we got to figure out a way to reverse that in the fourth quarter.
Thank you, Coach.
Talk to us about how against Baylor, everybody who touched the floor played well. He said this team, referring back to what we talked about maybe not having the somebody to carry the team, said this team needs four or five players to play really well. Maybe not great, but really well. They haven't had it through the first three quarters. A lot on the line, as you can see, for Connecticut. Do they get it here in the fourth?
Well, the thing that was most interesting to me was Holly asking, where does the team get their composure and confidence from? And he said, from me. And why? Because unlike these players, he's been in this moment many, many times. And so they just have to have the belief in themselves and him that they can make a run here in the fourth.
Ohio State, meanwhile, trying to protect a 10-point lead. Cody McMahon on the bench as Mikesell knocks in a three. And Ohio State has matched its largest lead. It is 13. Mikesell is now in a three in every game this season. Lou Lopez Seneschal flicks it ahead to Fudd. She will fire and hit. Connecticut could really use that from AZ Fudd. Edwards remains on the bench to begin the fourth quarter. Four fouls for Aaliyah Edwards. Her minutes have been severely limited all game long. Cody McMahon, the Big Ten freshman of the year with 20 points on the bench right now with her four fouls for Ohio State. And a whistle here against Griffin. as Ricky Harris will go to the line.
Ooh, what a screen by Harris, and that's the reason that Taylor Mikesell got so wide open last time down the floor.
Connecticut had closed things to five. It was 44-39 late in the third, and Ohio State responded well, as they did early in the game, to build the lead back up to double digits. Ohio State seeking its first Elite Eight since 1993. It is a 13-point Ohio State lead. Here's Juhas. Gets it across. Lou Lopez Senechal over to Fudd. Griffin has been quiet this game. Juhas spins. Lou Lopez Senechal given space. Short on a three. Offensive rebound. Couldn't be grabbed by Mule. Here's Sheldon for Ohio State.
Really smart decision by Sheldon to pull it out, understanding the clock is on their side right now.
Here's Theory. Had a really nice game. Tend to shoot. Sheldon zips it in the corner. Harris connects on a three. Ricky Harris makes it a 16-point Ohio State lead. Largest of the game, and a timeout taken by Connecticut.
Ohio State can bury you when they get hot from the three-point line. Ricky Harris knows it and feels it.
Ohio State with a 16-point fourth quarter lead on Connecticut here in Seattle, Washington. The last time Connecticut did not advance out of the Sweet 16, the last time they went west for a regional, Sylvia Fowles and LSU took them out 73-50, and Gino Auriemma's team in serious trouble here. Now, that was the last time they did not get to a Final Four, I should say, in 2007. Last time they didn't advance to the Elite Eight, you got to go back to 2005. Do they have a comeback left? Edwards back in with four fouls. Bud can't hit the jumper. Rebound controlled by Theory. Ohio State has done a wonderful job navigating with Cody McMahon on the bench. They have increased the lead by seven since McMahon had to go to the bench with a fourth foul.
A couple of things that they've done so well all game long. Number one, of course, turning Connecticut over. Number two, getting to the defensive glass and here to the offensive glass. And number three, driving in, getting to the free throw line and points in the paint.
Connecticut cannot secure the rebound. Here's Theory into the paint. Bounces for Walker. Great look inside. Bucket and a foul for Harris. It is all Ohio State.
The effort on this possession, just multiple looks by getting to the offensive glass again, getting touches in the paint. Time to celebrate that one for Ricky Harris.
Ricky Harris has made a massive impact off the bench in this game for Ohio State. We saw her part of the closing unit in the second round as Juhas deep seal and the finish on the delivery from Mule. Sheldon has been the astute conductor for the Buckeyes down the stretch, winding some more clock. It is the friend of Ohio State. Here's Sheldon into the paint. Got blocked. Edwards controls. Here comes Spud for Connecticut. And a foul on the floor against Theory. Well, still to come tonight, Virginia Tech. Yeah. Elizabeth Kinley ready to go. Virginia Tech, Tennessee, 6:30 Eastern on ESPN2. Rekia Jackson playing incredible basketball down the stretch for Tennessee. The winner of this game will meet the winner of that one. Edwards couldn't finish the layup. Sheldon comes up with it. And again, Sheldon going to wisely slow things down for Ohio State as McMahon gets ready to check back in. Sheldon packs it out. Mike Sell, no. Here comes Mule. Good look here. Lou Lopez Senechal knocks down the three. A much needed one for Connecticut. Breathing a little life into them.
Lou Lopez Senechal, without question, been Connecticut's best offensive player this whole game.
20 points now on 8 of 11 shooting. Will it be her final collegiate game? And a timeout taken by Ohio State as Sheldon was trapped. Well, for the third straight year, every NCAA Women's Basketball Championship game is on the networks of ESPN. For more information, go to NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA championships. All games are on the ESPN networks and the ESPN app. J.C. Sheldon missed 23 games because of a foot injury. She has been terrific since coming back to this tournament, defense and offense today.
She tends to be the most impactful player on both ends of the floor. Defensively, active hands. She's fast. Offensively, she knows when to play really fast and get them in their stuff. And we've seen her in the fourth quarter making really good decisions in terms of running her team in the quarter court.
13 points, 4 rebounds, 4 assists, 2 steals for J.C. Sheldon. The senior from Dublin, Ohio. Brother AJ plays basketball at Ohio University as they fumble the handoff. Connecticut has it. Here's Mule. Thud. Trying to get around Theory. Nothing there. Back out to Mule. Lopez Senechal dumps it in. Juhas turns and finishes. Connecticut making a little push here. It's an 11-point game.
And while Ohio State wants to be smart in terms of clock management, they have to continue to be in aggressor mode. That's where they've had so much success so far in this game.
Theory hands it off to Sheldon. Sheldon pedals it through, up, under, and off. Rebound Griffin, a chance here for Connecticut to cut it to single digits. A 7-0 run. Fudd gives it back. Mule lines it up. Can't hit from three. Would have been huge for Connecticut. Tie up here, and Connecticut has possession. We are going to welcome in our ESPN2 audience to what could be a really exciting finish here in Seattle, Washington. If you're just joining us, Connecticut on a 7-0 run. Ohio State leads by 11. They have forced 24 Connecticut turnovers in this game. Their press has been unbelievably effective. Ohio State trying to make the Elite Eight for the first time since 1993. You saw what was at stake for Connecticut. Juhas can't finish, kept it alive. Lopez Senechal gets fouled. And free throws here for Lou Lopez Senechal. Number 2 on Walker. All right, Rebecca, if you're Connecticut, you're starting to believe maybe you got a little something going here in this fourth.
Yeah, without question. They've been able to get stops on the defensive end of the floor. And when they've done that, Ohio State hasn't been able to set up in the press that's given them so much trouble. And it's going to be important for Connecticut to get these free points. They have not been good from the free throw line so far in this game.
5 of 12, whereas Ohio State is 17 for 23. They get them both there. Lou Lopez Senechal with 22. It's a single-digit deficit.
First time this game, Connecticut extending their pressure into the full court.
Sheldon, great look. Extra feed. Mike Sell waits, takes, can't hit. Mule fouls McMahon on the rebound. Looked like Nika Mule just cleared out Cody McMahon. And McMahon grabbing at that left elbow. And McMahon made sure to sell it. 9-point game. Ohio State has made just one of their last 8 field goal attempts. deflected out of bounds, stays here with Ohio State. Buckeyes led this game 64-46 with 7:19 to go. The 9-0 Connecticut run. Sheldon. The freshman McMahon, five to shoot. McMahon into the paint, leans in, finishes, plus the foul. Cody McMahon, poised and effective.
This young woman is a freshman, but look at her frame. One of the bigger, stronger players on the floor. Tyke takes it right at Aubrey Griffin, gets her to lean her arms, and man, what opportunity. Yeah, we know you're strong.
McMahon completes the three-point play, ends the 9-0 run, and the lead is back to 12. Fudd goes backdoor, great delivery from Juhas. Fudd lays it in, and then a foul called against Connecticut. Ohio State is in the bonus. And Griffin is called for the personal.
Aubrey Griffin going in to try to get an offensive rebounding position, and incidental contact is still contact. That
previous play is under review.
Called a foul. I have no idea why you'd be reviewing it, though. It's certainly not, to me, look like something that should be upgraded.
I mean,
it's fair to call it a common foul. You could have gone with nothing, but you go with a common foul, but I would not upgrade this in any way.
No. Gives each team a chance to huddle.
The call on the floor is confirmed. Personal foul on number 44, White. Number 4, Red, will shoot two shots.
So two shots here for Sheldon, who is an 84% career free throw shooter. Free throw is a huge story in this game. Ohio State 18 of 24, Connecticut 6 for 13. Ohio State a plus 12 at the line, a plus 10 on the scoreboard. Sheldon hits the first. She's been doing everything to stay on top of her rehab. His little sister Emmy loves what she sees. Laser treatment, ultrasound, heat, ice, whatever it takes to stay healthy after missing those 23 games. Kevin McGuff made sure not to push her, not to bring her back too soon, because wanted her at her best, and she has been here in the NCAA tournament. Lopez Sanichal again, doing everything she can to keep Connecticut alive.
If you're Ohio State, you want to use clock, but you want to finish the possession by being aggressive. It's worked so well for you the entire game. Dribble penetration towards the rim.
Sheldon has 15 points, lost the handle, got it back, 10 to shoot, backdoor, Mike Sell banks it in. Big buckets from McMahon, Mike Sell, and Sheldon have kept UConn at bay. 11-point Ohio State lead. And that's a foul on Sheldon. Side out of bounds for Connecticut.
Taylor Mike Sell is known as a sharp three-point shooter, but we have seen this three times. Her use her touch and lift to float the basketball up and kiss it off of the glass. Beautiful touch by Mike Sell.
Certainly one of the areas where her game has improved over the years.
Juhas, nice crossover. Dorka Juhas got banged, no call. Couldn't finish the layup. And here comes Mike Sell. Two minutes and 40 seconds to go. Ohio State trying to head to the Elite Eight for the first time since 1993. McMahon, four to shoot, fading, doesn't get the roll. Connecticut down 11, every possession precious. Mule flips it up and off, but gets the whistle. And Nika Mule is going to shoot two. And that is number 4 on Sheldon.
And interesting to note, too, as we just as I'm about to say it, she's coming into the game. Much of this push in the last few minutes has been without Aaliyah Edwards on the floor.
And Edwards has been instrumental in Connecticut's success of late, certainly their postseason success, but early foul trouble and never really have felt her impact in this game. As Mule hits the first. Mika Mule, seven turnovers. Misses the second free throw. Sheldon flags it down. Here's McMahon. Deflected, and Edwards comes up with a steal after Fudd hit it initially. AZ Fudd, the hesitation, the kick, and threw it away. A critical missed opportunity for Connecticut. 25th turnover for the Huskies. Here's McMahon, barges across the timeline. Ohio State gonna run clock here. Mike Sell gives it up. Sheldon thought about firing. She gets tripped. And J.C. Sheldon is going right back to the line with Ohio State leading by 10 and firmly in control. Connecticut without Paige Beckers all season long still managed to get to their 29th straight Sweet 16. But Ohio State's press has overwhelmed Connecticut in this game. That's what set the tone towards the end of the first quarter and throughout the entire second, and Connecticut has never been able to recover.
And so much of that is credit to J.C. Sheldon and what she's done on the defensive end of the floor, and I think she's been masterful offensively as well. Knowing when to attack, getting touches in the paint off of dribble penetration, and then this latter part of the fourth quarter, she slowed things down and really led her team.
Sheldon, 17 points. She's 10 of 10 from the line. Here's Mule hooking it out. Connecticut's got to move in a hurry. Lopez Seneschal fades, can't hit. Sheldon the rebound. And it is becoming apparent what this is going to look like when the clock hits triple zeros. Mike Sell to McMahon. Eight to shoot. McMahon going to get called for the offensive foul, and that will be her fifth. And Cody McMahon is fouled out.
She's been so good and so aggressive throughout this game. And on that dribble penetration, she used her left arm to hook as she was attacking with the right. But you're not going to fault her for that, because this 12-point lead and perhaps victory for Ohio State is going to be in large part due to the play of Cody McMahon.
23 points for Cody McMahon. Here's Fudd. She will fire. Can't hit. Rebound poked out to Lopez Seneschal. Ducharme into the lane. Can't hook it in. Rebound Harris. She's fouled. And with 54.7 seconds to go, Ricky Harris goes to the free throw line. And Kevin McGuff's team is just seconds away from an Elite Eight berth. Meanwhile, for Connecticut, it'll be the first time since 2005 that they lose in the Sweet 16. An unbelievable run. And you heard Gino Auriemma talk to Holly Rowe before the start of the fourth. Everything we didn't do well all season has finally caught up with us tonight. AZ Fudd can't hit the three. Knocked off Mike Sell. 45 seconds to go. Let's take a look at our Capital One rewarding performance. Ohio State's defense sensational.
They set the tone from the absolute jump of this game, wreaking havoc on UConn, turning them over, getting easy looks the other way, speeding Connecticut up in the quarter court as well.
Harris, the rebound, off to Sheldon. Connecticut is not going to foul. The Ohio State faithful rising to their feet.
Connecticut's final four streak will end. Their Elite Eight streak will end. Mike Sell. Harris, the rainbow. It tilts out of bounds, and it is all cosmetic at this point. With 12 and a half seconds to go. Stunning for some, not for Ohio State. A team that started this season 19-0. Ohio State is headed to the Elite Eight for the first time since 1993. They take down Connecticut, 73-61 the final.
Incredible performance by Ohio State from the tip of this game to the final buzzer sounded. They imposed their will and defensively got after Connecticut on the offensive end. They were in attack mode on both ends of the floor the entire game, and they are going to the Elite Eight as a result.
J.C. Sheldon with Holly.
Well, J.C., this team's defensive effort forcing UConn into turnovers, problems. How did you dig down in the biggest moments?
Yeah, I think that's 22 there. Our press is what we rely on, and sticking together and talking through it. And we knew UConn was going to be ready for it, so we knew we were going to have to, you know, stay consistent throughout the game.
I think it amazed me that it never wore down. You guys never wore down through this entire game. Where does that stamina and that grit come from?
Oh, man, that's on coach. That's on our staff and our strength coach. They keep us in shape all year and make us ready for moments like these.
Offensively, Cody was big early. You were big late. How did the balance of this offense get this win?
Yeah, that's what we emphasized coming into this game. We knew we were going to be able to get to the rim, and then we wanted the balance on outside as well. So Cody's a great player, and she did really well tonight.
You seem so calm. You know you're going to the Elite Eight, right?
Yeah. Hasn't sunk in yet.
Thanks, JC.
Thank you, Holly.
Well, JC Sheldon, the senior leader of Ohio State, a tremendous performance for her and Kevin McGuff's entire team. Ohio State has punched its ticket. They will play in the Elite Eight Monday night, 9 Eastern, here on ESPN. Who will they play? That depends what happens next on ESPN2 with Tennessee and Virginia Tech. Once again, the final score, Ohio State 73, UConn 61. For our producer, Kerry Callahan, our director, Jimmy Platt, Holly Rowe, Andrea Carter, and the Hall of Famer, Rebecca Lobo. I'm Ryan Rucco. Coming up next on ABC, it's ABC World News Tonight on your local news over most of these ABC stations. On ESPN2, we take you to L. Duncan in the studio, and then it's Tennessee and Virginia Tech with a trip to the Elite Eight on the line to meet Ohio State.